Get ready to match the stars. Avery Schreiber, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Nancy Kulp, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, Johnny Olson and friends. Some of you people are sitting in the front row there, not paying any attention to what's going on. And already you've missed eight jokes, because these are all witty, gay, amusing people.
Well, that's what
you know,
said.
They look real, don't they?
They are.
Oh, all yeah. Right.
Don't say that. Get your hands off my real pearls.
Let's say hello to Paula Miller and Sherry Sato. Paula's a current champ, right? How much money do you want?
8,000.
8,800.
800.
$8,800. What are you gonna do with all that loot?
Oh, I told you first to gotta get a water bed for my son.
Oh yeah, you had an 8-year-old son. You're gonna buy a water bed for the kid.
Buy a lake for the kid.
What else?
A roof for my house.
A roof for your house.
It's leaking. Yes.
Yes. Well, get the water bed first and let it leak, and then you'll have some water for the water. Anyway. Anyway, we're gonna start here in the middle of round two. The score is 4-1 at this moment. And Sherry is doing pretty well here in challenging you. You've got to match three celebrities to achieve a tie. You could win it, however, if you match four. You ready?
Ready.
We're not. This is for you first, and then we'll get back to her. We are ready to carry on. I will push this button, reveal the final question in this game, except if it ends up as a tie. Paula Miller. Brett does not play. And she's the only one. Everybody else, if you would respond to this, please.
Yes.
Gloria said, my husband used to be a parachute jumper. And that's why he yells, Geronimo, every time he blinks. My husband used to be a parachute jumper, and that's why he yells, Geronimo, every time he blinks.
Oh boy,
how are you?
I'm not like playing this round.
Yes, how have you been?
Oh, I've been very well.
Very well. Then.
Didn't we have a nice time last night?
Yes, we did. Terrific.
Don't tell Helen.
She's only fudging. Come on now,
ladies.
You were in the service, weren't you?
Yeah, but I never jumped out of anything.
Really?
Well, hardly ever. Fell off a telephone pole. Oh, my God.
Oh, these people are already there.
Everyone's ready, Avery.
Oh, Avery.
Even Charles is ready, and he's never ready. But don't get nervous. Charles is always the last one, Avery, but you've beaten him.
Okay. Now we come to Paula Miller. Gloria said, my husband used to be a parachute jumper, and that's why he yells Geronimo every time he blanks.
He leaps into bed.
Really? It's an interesting idea, but I think you blew the game. What did you say?
Well, you know, I was really pressed for time.
Yes, you were. You really couldn't think of anything, could you?
No, I couldn't. It was all dirty. Anyhow, I said every time he arrives.
All right. Every time he walks in the door or something like that. Hey. There he goes. But he did yell Geronimo. What do you say, Charles?
All those potato chips, you know.
Yes. I know, they're getting to his
makes
brain.
Makes love.
Every time he makes love.
Jumping into bed.
Now, Paula, you must match the three remaining celebrities here on the lower tier to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Nancy Kulp, what do you say?
Are we the lower tier?
You are the lower tier. That's why he yells Geronimo every time he...
Well, it's a derivative thereof. Dives into bed.
Dives into bed? Interesting response.
Thank you.
Now, Richard?
I said makes love.
Every time he makes love, so that means Sherry Sato wins the game. What'd you have, Joyce?
She's gonna
faint. Don't come
back
now. All right. We'll get to you in a moment or so. You need a little help? There you go. Paula Miller, you're not leaving here empty-handed, are you?
No, I'm not.
$8,800. Does that make you happy? Thank you. Now, there it is, Sherry. You could win over $5,000 here now. Shall we plunge on ahead?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's commercial time.
No, I'm not. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Buzz blank. Now, the answer that group gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match that middle one, you get $250, then the bottom one gets you $100, and you can get a little help from our celebrities.
Richard Dawson, please.
Buzzsaw.
Buzzsaw is one.
Charles.
Buzz off!
Avery.
Buzz Aldrin.
Buzz Aldrin. Okay, so they are Buzz Aldrin, Buzzsaw, and Buzz Off. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own doing if you wish.
Buzz Off.
Buzz Off is what you want? Audience thinks you've chosen the right one. We'll find out right now. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Buzz Aldrin.
Aldrin.
That was up there?
Had it wrong.
Okay, that might be a good omen for you, my dear. Let's see if Buzz Off is under the $250 number. Buzz Saw is the one that Richard gave you. Let's see if Charles Nelson Reilly's answer comes up now as we reveal the $500 number. Yes. Very good. Now you have a total of $600, but more important, Sherry, you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Remember to collect. You've got to match one of them exactly, and you have to choose one now.
Well, since he gave me Buzz Off, I'm going to go with Charles.
All right, Charles, you get ready to write. You stand on the old adhesive tape there, and I'll get the one that's worth $5,000 and get your ESP going over to Charles, because he's got his going over to you, and it reads like this. Second-hand blank. Second-hand blank. Charles is finished. Now, Sherry, what answer would you like to give us that'll match his and give you the $5,000? Second-hand...
Rose.
Second-hand rose. From the song of the same name. Charles, she says that'll match you for $5,000.
I thought because it's a song, it's, you know, limited. And
yes.
So I said second-hand rose.
Back to another player in a moment or so. Start another game after we show you these messages. Now, as we are ready to carry on and start a brand new game, what do you say we all give a brisk round of applause to our new player, Gail Warren, by the way. Gail, we welcome you.
I thank you.
Now, we want to know a little bit about you.
Okay, I'm originally from Brooklyn, New York. I'm married.
Yeah.
Well, married. With one son, and I have two on the way, my second and my third.
Really?
That's
Is
fine.
That confirmed?
Yes, it's confirmed.
Would you bring my stethoscope, please? Two on the way.
Yes. I enjoy swimming and dancing and taking care of my plants, and I'm very happy to be here.
What rule of thumb do you have about taking care of plants?
Well, I have found that you can water them too much. That kills them faster than anything.
Very good point. Do not overwater your plants.
Hit them with a stick and get their attention. Run.
Yeah. Now, Gail, you may have A or B.
B for babies.
B for babies.
Plural.
Girl doesn't have a hobby, does she?
Doesn't have time for a hobby.
She ain't gonna have no time for them plants once them twins get here.
That's true. Listen to this now. The Pied Piper said... He said, I was just hired to round up all the rats in America. It's going to be easy because all the rats are in blank. You all understand. Very good.
I understand.
Terrific. Great answer.
Thank you.
Same as mine.
All right. Terrific.
Well, you're going to have twins, Jean. You're going to meet a tall, dark stranger.
Ready over there? Okay.
How could you know?
We're going back now to talk to Dale Warren. The Pied Piper said, I was just hired to round up all the rats in America, and it's going to be easy, because all the rats are in...
Could you say it again?
Yes, I'll say it again. You know who the Pied Piper was?
Yes.
All the little kids followed him. He said, I was just hired to round up all the rats in America. And it's going to be easy because all the rats are in...
Washington.
Well, this is an election year, Jean.
What do you say, Senator?
I say she's right.
Whoa, there's one for her. And you, madam?
I say somebody tell me who to vote for. I said this may be a match. Our nation's capital.
Okay. She's a Laurel and Hardy all by herself.
She should wear gloves.
Yes.
Washington.
Yes. You're wearing your bicentennial shirt, yeah. I see. That's
red
very
for the red, white,
that's very nice there. All right, Nancy Kulp.
Yes.
It's going to be easy to round up all the rats in America because all the rats are in Washington, according to her and her and him and him.
Well, I said, across the Potomac in Washington.
That's another one. Hey, you got four, Gale. Richard, where are they?
No dirty rats. UTC.
That is. Perfect, Gale. Well, Gale, it's time... to burst the bubble. Time to burst your little bubble.
Wouldn't it be something if I said something that everybody else said, and I did.
You did. Fried the heck out of me. Now, you want A, don't you? Because that's the only one that's left there. Okay, everybody plays. This is our first round question. The mad scientist went into his laboratory and tried out a new method for creating life.
Uh-oh.
But he got careless, and now his blank is stuck in a test tube.
Say again.
Mad scientist went to his laboratory, tried out a new method for creating life, but he got careless, and now his blank is stuck in a test tube.
Way to make a living. I want to go be a box girl to say.
Yes, you do understand the question.
Yeah, you do.
Come on now, put something down.
Creating what? Life?
Life. We're creating life.
His
yes,
blank
Charles.
Got stuck
got
in the test tube.
Oh, well, that could hurt.
Tricky. It's a tricky
question.
It's a tricky question.
It's an interesting question, though.
Yes,
of course. Yes. I mean, the things that have been happening in the scientific world in recent months. Come on, write something. Don't just stand around staring into space. That's not
bad. Now, what was I can't have to...
There it is.
Oh, no need to get testing.
I am testing.
It's a test tube question.
Test tube question. This is a mash note.
Okay. We're going to start with that.
All right, I got it.
Now, Sherry, are you ready?
No, I can hear it.
All right, we'll give it to you one more time. The mad scientist went into his laboratory and tried out a new method for creating life. But he got careless. And now his blank is stuck in a test tube. Leave her alone.
Right.
Just give us an answer and we'll press on.
His body. I can't.
His body. Okay, that's her answer. She said his body got stuck in the test tube. Must have been a big one, but that's the way it is.
You see, I saw him. Wife.
Yeah, you got careless house wife is stuck in a test tube. All right.
Now, I would like to preface my answer with saying I really had no idea what that question meant. I didn't understand.
It was one of those wide-open questions. Yeah, you know, it's a first-round question.
They can, wide open.
They can run far afield.
Sure.
Come on, now, show the answer.
He was working with somebody and his assistant got shot.
Okay. That's perfectly acceptable. Rotten but acceptable. Charles?
I chose finger, Jim.
Okay. Finger's a pretty good answer.
You can't
have working
no
around
taste.
There. In the laboratory, you know, with the test tubes.
Yeah, I understand.
His fingers got stuck in a test tube.
Yes, well, deductive reasoning, Mr. We have the same thinking.
Another
finger. That's two fingers in the test tube.
Right. His tongue got stuck in the test tube.
Even as you think.
That's right.
But seriously, folks, well, I have created life.
Yeah.
You may not like it, but there it is.
It really hurts, doesn't it?
Well.
Okay.
I don't know.
Golly, golly. Who have you been kissing? Come on, Joyce, tell us your answer.
I said his tube got stuck in a test tube. His tube.
We're on the round one, score of 6-0. You'll have a choice of A or B when we press on. But right now, we have to do a little business with America. Here it is. Here we go, round two, final round now. Now, since she's matched all the celebrities, normally she'd have her choice of A or B, but she's done it all, we give you your choice of A or B here, and you've got to match everybody to achieve a tie.
B, please.
B, all right, here it goes. Everybody plays. Dumb Donald decided... You haven't rehearsed your part. Dumb Donald decided to become an actor.
That's
but Donald figure. Was so dumb when he...
Sorry.
Okay. When he went to the casting office, he brought along a blank. That's how dumb he was. Donald was so dumb when he went to the casting office, he brought along a blank. Okay. Okay, okay. Sorry, I didn't mean to muss your hair there. Sherry, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, we'll plow on. Dumb Donald decided to become an actor. But Donald was so dumb when he went to the casting office, he brought along a...
Cast.
A cast. That's good.
I hope so.
That's one of two, maybe three good possibilities. Two that I can think of. Cast. Now, she's got to match everybody to stay in the game. She's looking for a cast.
I feel like a killer.
Why?
I had a rotten reel.
A rotten reel is a very good answer, so that means you're on one.
Hey, you go there.
And I'll move the cable for you there. Well, Sherry Central, you're going to leave here with a lot of loot, specifically $5,600.
Super.
We're very happy
Thank
for you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, there goes Sherry. Now, you can win a big bundle of money here now, as she did, and her predecessors did, too. We polled a recent studio audience, Gail, and we got their best response to this. Family blank, $500. If you match the answer they gave most frequently, $250 for the middle one and $100 for the bottom. Whom do you call on here?
Richard.
What do you say, Richard?
It'd be such a good one if I can just think of it.
Family.
It's a show I've seen on television.
Oh, it's marvelous. Yes, I know.
It's on at 11:30 on another network.
Yes.
Which
Family.
To be ABC.
We're running a little late there.
Family Feud.
Family Feud. There's one.
Charles.
Charles?
What Gail is going to need after the twins, family plan.
Right.
Brett.
What do you say, Brett?
Oh, family affair.
Family affair, family feud, and family plan. Now, you want one of those?
Yes.
Which one?
Family feud.
Family feud. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Family tree is a good answer. Looking for family feud under the $250 response. Feud it is! Very good, you got the $250. Terrific. Now, that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, but before we can go on to that... Oh, you want to see the big one? All right, let's reveal it right now. Affair it is. Okay. Now, you don't go away. Stand here with me while we do a little business with America, all right? Okay. Well, gang, you've done it again. And you'll have a chance to do it another time. So next time we get together, these are the bodies who will be on this stage, alive.
Jimmy Walker, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Rod Skelly, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
How about that lineup? Okay, you join us for Match Game 76. Team Rayburn here. So long.
Good night.
Interesting idea, but I think you blew the game. What did you say?
Well, you know, I was really pressed for time.
Yes, you were. You really couldn't think of anything, could you?
No, I couldn't. It was all dirty. Anyhow, I said every time he arrives.
All right. Every time he walks in the door or something like that. Hey. There he goes. Yeah, but he did yell Geronimo. What do you say, Charles?
All those potato chips, you know.
Yes. I know, they're getting to his
makes
brain.
Makes love.
Every time he makes love.
Start jumping into bed.
Now, Paula, you must match the three remaining celebrities here on the lower tier to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Nancy Kulp, what do you say?
Are we the lower tier?
You are the lower tier. That's why he yells Geronimo every time he...
Well, it's a derivative thereof. Dives into bed.
Dives into bed? Very interesting response.
Thank you.
Now, Richard?
I said makes love.
Every time he makes love, so that means Sherry Sato wins the game. What'd you have, Joyce?
He's gonna fail.
Don't pull it out now.
Stand on the adhesive tape.
All right. We'll get to you in a moment or so. You need a little help? There you go. Paula Miller, you're not leaving here empty-handed, are you? $8,800. Does that make you happy? There it is, Sherry. You can win over $5,000 here now. Shall we plunge on ahead?
Yeah.
Okay, Charles, because he's got his going over to you, and it reads like this. Second-hand blank. Second-hand blank. Charles is finished. Now, Sherry, what answer would you like to give us that'll match his and give you the $5,000? Second-hand...
Rose.
Second-hand rose. From the song of the same name. Charles, she says that'll match you for $5,000.
I thought because it's a song, it's, you know, limited. And
yes.
So I said second-hand rose.
Back to another player in a moment or so. Start another game after we show you these messages. Now, as we are ready to carry on and start a brand new game, what do you say we all give a brisk round of applause to our new player, Gail Warren, over there. Gail, we welcome you.
I thank you.
Now, we want to know a little bit about you.
Okay, I'm originally from Brooklyn, New York. I'm married.
It's commercial time.
No, I'm not. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Buzz blank. Now, the answer that group gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match that middle one, you get $250, then the bottom one gets you $100, and you can get a little help from our celebrities.
Richard Dawson, please.
Buzzsaw.
Buzzsaw is one.
Charles.
Buzz off!
Avery.
Buzz Aldrin.
Buzz Aldrin. Okay, so they are Buzz Aldrin, Buzzsaw, and Buzz Off. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own doing if you wish.
Buzz Off.
Buzz Off is what you want? Audience thinks you've chosen the right one. We'll find out right now. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Buzz Aldrin.
Aldrin.
That was up there?
Had it wrong.
Okay, that might be a good omen for you, my dear. Let's see if Buzz Off is under the $250 number. Buzz Saw is the one that Richard gave you. Let's see if Charles Nelson Reilly's answer comes up now as we reveal the $500 number. Yes. Very good. Now you have a total of $600, but more important, Sherry, you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Remember to collect. You've got to match one of them exactly, and you have to choose one now.
Well, since he gave me Buzz Off, I'm going to go with Charles.
All right, Charles. You get ready to write. You stand on the old adhesive tape there, and I'll get the one that's worth $5,000 and get your ESP going over to Charles.
Get ready to match the star. Avery Schreiber. Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Nancy Kulp, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Hello, Johnny Olson and friends. Some of you people are sitting in the front row there, not paying any attention to what's going on. And already you've missed 8 jokes, because these are all witty, gay, amusing people.
Well, that's what
you know,
you said.
They look real, don't they?
They are.
Oh, all yeah. Right.
Don't say that. Get your hands off my real pearls.
Let's say hello to Paula Miller and Sherry Sato. Paula's a current champ, right? How much money do you want?
8,000.
8,800.
800.
$8,800. What are you gonna do with all that loot?
Oh, I told you first, gotta get a water bed for my son.
Oh yeah, you had an 8-year-old son. You're gonna buy a water bed for the kid.
Buy a lake for the kid.
What else?
A roof for my house.
A roof for your house.
It's leaking, yes.
Yes. Well, get the water bed first and let it leak, and then you'll have some water for the water. Well, anyway. Anyway, we're going to start here in the middle of round two. The score is 4-1 at this moment. And Sherry is doing pretty well here in challenging you. You've got to match 3 celebrities to achieve a tie. You could win it, however, if you match 4. You ready?
Ready.
We're not. This is for you first, and then we'll get back to her. We are ready. To carry on, I will push this button, reveal the final question in this game, except if it ends up as a tie. Paula Miller, Brett does not play, and she's the only one. Everybody else, if you would respond to this, please.
Yes.
Gloria said, my husband used to be a parachute jumper, and that's why he yells, Geronimo, every time he blanks. My husband used to be a parachute jumper, and that's why he yells Geronimo every time he blinks. Oh, boy, oh, boy. How are you?
I'm not like playing that? This time.
Yes. How have you been?
Oh, I've been very well. Hospital.
Very well.
Didn't we have a nice time last night?
Yes, we did. Terrific.
Don't tell Helen.
She's only fudging. Come on, now,
Avery.
You were in the service, weren't you?
Yeah, but I never jumped out of anything.
Really?
Well, hardly ever. Fell off a telephone pole. Oh, my God.
Well, these people are all ready there.
Everyone's ready, Avery.
Coach Avery.
Even Charles is ready, and he's never ready. But don't get nervous. Charles is always the last one, Avery, but you've beaten him.
Okay. Now we come to Paula Miller. Gloria said, my husband used to be a parachute jumper, And that's why he yells Geronimo every time he blanks.
He leaps into bed.